but Hornets. Well, they take on this Knicks team I mentioned off the top, 5-1 to start the season. Tom Thibodeau is shaking up his starting lineup, benching Kemba Walker. He's now officially out of the rotation, and these are the numbers that explain the puzzle he's been trying to solve. And it was basically the case against Brooklyn on Tuesday night. The starters had negative marks in terms of their plus-minus. Derrick Rose had the best plus-minus of anybody at plus 11 coming off the bench. And this has been the way it's been for the New York Knicks this year.
It has. And Kemba Walker, while you look at those numbers, obviously he hasn't been playing well. But really, the only other option was Evan Fournier. And I don't think from a personnel standpoint it would have made sense to pull Fournier because he can still fill that two-guard position. And there are going to be a lot of nights where they're going to be okay with Burks in the starting lineup, because they do have, in essence, two lead guards coming off the bench with Quickley and Derrick Rose. So if they're going up against a point guard who's giving them a lot of problems, especially in the pick and roll, they can immediately then go and get a point guard. But I think it's important, big picture, too, that Fournier be given the opportunity to figure it out, because his upside in terms of what they want to do, I think, makes more sense, big picture, for them. They're going to need his shooting and scoring at that off-guard position. He can also make plays. And now there's just less that they have to try and figure out. And at this point, unless he can get completely healthy, Kemba really hadn't been that effective in terms of his scoring or his defense. And
right.
So this is a team right now, because of the expectations and because when they look around and see how all these other teams have vastly improved, there starts to be a little concern for the New York Knicks. And this will be a great challenge for them, because this is one of the teams that they're going to be competing for if they want to have any chance to get home court in that first round.
And it's possible just the rest of the East got better around the New York Knicks. Is it possible also, Sean, that the 6-8 version of the Knicks since that hot start is really the more representative record for this New York team?
Yeah, I would say so. I mean, the other thing is that if you look at the Knicks, especially their young players, you haven't seen the growth, the next step for R.J. Barrett, Emmanuel Quickley, Obi Toppin. You know, they're still the same players they were last year. That's one reason why they have pretty much an average record. And until you start to see a breakout from at least one of them, you can probably say, okay, the second half of the season, they're going to take the next step up. But Obi Toppin, I know he's had some flashes off the bench in that second unit that's been playing very well for them. But he's got great athleticism. But where's the mid-range jumper? Where are the things he worked on over the summer? Creating off the dribble. R.J. Barrett, we thought at this point he would take the next step up, maybe challenge, Julius Randle for the scoring lead. He's still a solid number two guy. So I think what the Knicks are hoping for is some growth. You know, now that this sort of revamped starting lineup is here, some growth. This is a healthy team, too, by the way. It's not like they're missing a key piece.
Right.
And if you look at some of the other teams in the East, Philadelphia, Brooklyn, they're missing something. They have an excuse. The Knicks really don't have an excuse. So you're wondering, what is the real Knicks team?